Question 6 of the GED math practice test part 1, that's the part with calculator. It says, Ralph bought several containers of sand so he could make sand paintings. He now wants to consolidate all the sand into one big container. According to the picture, that's the pictures below, how many of the little containers of sand, okay, this is a small container, this is a large container, okay, how many of the little containers of sand will he be able to fit into the big container of sand? Okay, so how many of these little containers of sand will he be able to fit into the big container of sand? Okay, so that means how many quantity of sand would he pour in here? Okay, that's and that would fill in what the large container of sand here. So maybe he would fill, when he fills this up, he pours in, okay, it's not yet full, he has to fill this small container up again, pour into the large container, it might still not be full. So we need to know how many quantity of containers of sand, of the small container of sand, he needs to fill in what the large container. So to do this, we need to find the volume of the small container and also the volume of the large container. Then what do we do? We now divide the volume of the large container by the volume of the small container to know how many containers of this how many containers of this small the small one would fit into the large water container. Okay, so remember, what's the volume we're dealing with? Okay, this is a cylinder here, and this is a cube, this is a cylinder, this is a cylinder, and what's the volume of a cylinder? I hope you remember, you'll be giving your formula sheet. So the volume of a cylinder, so you know, you don't need to cram formulas, you'll be giving your formula sheet, so it's easy for you. So the volume of a cylinder is what, pi r square h. What volume of a cube? Okay, the volume of a cube is just simply you must just multiply the three sides, okay, which is what L cube. All right, that's the three lengths, the length, you know, the cube, all the three, the length, the breadth, the height is what equal. All right, so it's just L times B times what, H, okay, which is L cube. All right, because the length, the breadth, the height is what equal. All right, so let's find the volume of the small container. All right, so here I think, okay, yes, this is one. Yes, this is one. Yeah, it's not quite clear. Okay, so this is one. So we have to find the volume of this small cylinder on top, then the volume of the what, cube, added together, we're going to get the volume of the small container. Okay, so let's just write small container volume is equal to, what's the volume of the cube here? Okay, let me just say cube plus cylinder. Alright, so the cube will be what? This is 3 times 3 times 3. Okay, that's 3 times 3 times 3. Then plus the cylinder will be what? Pi times what? The radius of the cylinder on top of this small container is 1. So pi, that's 1 squared times, and the height from here to here is also 1 centimeter. So sorry, this should be multiplication times the height, which is what, 1 centimeter. So from here, what is 3 times 3 times 3? That will give us what, 27. All right, so from here we have 1 square is still 1 times 1 is still 1, and pi will be given in your formula sheet as what, 3.14. okay, so when you add this up together, what are we going to get? We're going to have what, 30.14 centimeters. So this volume of the small what, container. Okay, all right, follow me closely. Okay, now let's go to the volume of the large container. Large container volume. Okay, so we have two cylinders here, the small one on top and the bigger one. All right, okay, so let's say big plus small here. All right, okay, so the big one is this one here. All right, well, our formula, what's our formula? Our formula is pi r square, the big r square, big h, plus by the small r, the small h. Okay, so where our pi will still be what, our pi will be 3.14. Okay, so we have here our big R is what, 3 centimeters? Is that not it? 3 centimeters. So we have times what, 3 square, and our big H is from here to here. This is our big R. That's the radius of the what, bigger cylinder. Our big H is what, the height of the what, bigger cylinder is what, times what, 5. Then plus pi. A small radius, which is the radius of the small cylinder, is what, this from here to here, which is what, 1.5. So times 1.5 square times, and the height of the small cylinder on top of it, what is 2 centimeters. So times what, 2. Okay, so here we have here pi, which is what, 3.14 times 3 square is what, 9 times 5. Okay, plus 3.14 times 1.5 square will give us 2.25 times 2. Okay, if you multiply this all together, punch in your calculator, multiply this, we're going to have this. For this, we're going to have 14.3, then plus, we're going to have here 14.13. okay, and when we add this up, what are we going to have? We're going to have 155.43 centimeter. Okay, so this is the volume of the large container, and what is the volume of the small container? So to know how many of the small container, the sand of the small container would fit into the large container, all we need to do is just say 155.43 divide by what, 30.14, and when you punch this into your calculator, you're going to have 5.1569. okay, from here we can see our answer is given in 2 decimal places. Okay, so let's approximate this to 2 decimal places. So here, what do we have here? So this will be 5, then after the point we count 1, 2, then the next number immediately after this particular, the second value, the second number here is 6, which we can approximate. Okay, that's is greater than 5. We can carry 1 to this to add up to our 5 here, which will make what, 6. So in approximating this to 2 decimal places, we have 5.16. okay, we'll carry 1 from here to add up to our 5 here, and we have 6. So this is our answer, and our right option here is option 4.